Dishonored 2 can be played in many ways, whether you prefer stealth, a mix of stealth and combat, or a purely aggressive path through the game. Within these greater choices, you also have a huge range of abilities and routes that influence how the game feels and challenges you. Here are a few suggestions that make it easier to adjust as you start playing the game. It's easy to end up in a larger battle than you expect. You see a patroller wandering around and think, "Hey, let's go kill that guy." It's a perfectly fair idea, but you might not know about the two men in the side room who are within earshot. And then there's the other patroller who might wander into the room once the fight starts. Things can get out of hand without much warning. Even as a combative player, you need to think a bit stealthy before you engage in a fight. Stay quiet when you're outside of combat and look around before you attack anyone. If you see enemies who are absolutely isolated, take them out immediately. If you use stealth assassinations, you can kill these enemies and still get the jump on other targets before the loud, chaotic battle begins. It's easy to kill one or two people at once, so keep your options open by engaging in these stealth kills. Most enemies patrol and watch major entrances and avenues through the area. They don't spend much of their time looking at rooftops, abandoned buildings, and other non-traditional routes. Because of this, you can sneak easily and somewhat quickly by getting above your enemies or around them. Explore these optional paths. Save your game and explore without worrying about lethality, being spotted, yada yada yada. Just run around and look for anything useful. After finding a few interesting possibilities, load your game again and reach those spots quietly. Doing this can actually be faster than exploring quietly in the first place. And it's kind of relaxing to spend a minute or two wandering around without being quiet and cautious. Bone charms grant your character minor bonuses. You benefit from these whenever you equip a bone charm. These items can include up to 4 positive effects and a single negative effect if they've been corrupted. Corrupted bone charms are either found with a negative trait or can be accidentally created that way if you use bone charm crafting as one of your abilities. Because the bone charm crafting system is so strong, we recommend that every character look into this. You can sacrifice the bone charms you find, learn their traits for future crafting, and get raw whalebone in the process. This raw whalebone is then used to make your own bone charms. You're allowed to stack the same positive effect up to 4 times on your character. For instance, an effect that gives you health whenever you do X can be applied up to 4 times. To get a merciful rating, you cannot kill any person during your play. Bloodflies, fish, rats, clockwork soldiers, and bloodbriars are still free game, because none of them are people. Save bullets and bolts for these enemies. And use abilities, non-lethal takedowns, and sleep darts to get through the rest of your work. When faced with an important target, always look for the special solution. Each major NPC has a kill scenario as well as a way to defeat them without lethal violence. Spend the extra time to go through these cool alternatives. You don't have to be a pure stealth player to pull off Merciful. If you upgrade your sleep darts, you can use them effectively in combat. That's it for this Prima Tips video. For more content like this, be sure to head over to primagames.com.